So, good evening all of you. Okay, yesterday we have gone through how to create the different layers. Hello. Shall I continue? Okay. Yesterday we have gone through the how to create the layers and how to create the plan. Okay. So in that also how to create the window and doors. Okay. So how to show this lawn and all. And also we gone through some elevations. That is front elevation. Okay. So today we will go for the section now. I'll just take one section here. Take a section like this. Okay, say it as A, T for text. Okay, just type it as A, caps A. Okay, and you just mirror this somewhere like this. No, okay, so this is my AA section now. Okay, in section we are seeing this portion, this window and this. Okay, or else we can draw this portion also, no problem. Okay, I will just elaborate this walls. Okay, keep the current layer as a wall and you just leave this boundary and say match property and match it. Deselect. Match property, select the wall which you want to match and then match it like this. Okay, either you can go to the L or you can go to the XL, that is construction line. Just draw it like this. In section we are able to see the thickness of the wall also. Okay, so that's why I'm going to show the thickness also. XL. Okay, in section I am going to see this wall and this wall and this wall. Okay, so that's why I'm just extending this like this. Escape. Repeat the same process by pressing space. Okay, cancel, and again repeat the same command by pressing the space. Okay. I just took the wall now, just extend this. Okay, here also for a purpose I just draw one ground level. Ground level to plinth level is how much? 0.6. okay, give 0.6. escape, and again offset 3 meter for floor to floor distance. Okay, again offset 0.15 for the slab thickness, same as for the elevation. Just we are in the section we are going to show the thickness of the wall, that's it. And delete the unwanted portion, that is construction lines. Okay, or else you can delete it, or else you can trim it. No, trim it. Okay, so just trim it like this. Trim. No, I need this for the foundation purpose. Okay, you just trim the here. Go to trim and just trim this. This is slab, right? This should be uniform. Okay. I trim the unwanted portion. And here also, as I told you yesterday, give the 0.15 offset for plinth purpose. Plinth and slab are extended about 0.5 meter. Okay. Just trim this, and this. Okay, this and also this one. Okay. And also this, delete this extra portion. Now control Z. Okay, this one. trim this and trim this. Okay. So this is my ground level and this is my plinth level and these are the walls. As in the section, we are able to see the three walls. This one and this one, right? Yeah. And this is slab. Okay. So in section, we are able to see the material of the wall. Okay. So I have to show the pattern here. For that, before going to hash, you just confirm whether it is closed or not. You just close it like this so that hash will apply. Otherwise, not. Take a rectangle and then you can use the short keys or you can go to the command. Okay. Hash for the hash and go for the wall now. In section, we are able to see the walls like this. Yeah, like this. Now it is tape. Masonry. Yes, this one. Okay, apply to this closed boundary. And here. And here. Okay, you just change the scale factor here. 0.1. Okay. 0.2. What is? There is no standard value for this. Just give the value which one you feel good to see. Yeah, this is ball 0.3 or 0.4. Okay, so this is my brick masonry. And slab is concrete. Okay, so before going to hash, you just confirm the boundary. Okay, it is not closed one. You can take a rectangular and draw it again, or else you can just select. I will just telling you the options. Okay, you just select this like this and J enter means join. Now it's closed boundary. Okay, so hatch H, go for the concrete now. Yeah, and apply it. Okay, and change the value 0.01 or 0.02, whatever it may be. Okay, then close it. So in plinth also, as I shown in the elevation, pebbles, right? You can show the pebbles or you can show the UCR also. Okay, again, H. And then go for the pebbles or grovels, okay? Wait for a moment. Just loading. And increase the value as 1. Yeah. Like this. Like this. Okay. Here also. Here also. And here also. Okay. So this is my plinth now. In section. Okay. So my window is cutted here. So this window and this window. Right. So in elevation, we are able to see at 2.1 meter height. So means we will just take this dimension from here to here is 2.1, right? Okay. We have to show that portion in the section also. From here to here. This is 2.1. What is the height of the window? Yeah, 1 meter. Okay. Go to the section. Just draw one line for the reference purpose. Okay. Okay. And give offset as 0.9 meter. That is our lintel level. Okay. And again, repeat the command O and 1 meter for height of the window. Okay. Okay. Then we have to show the window here. Where? So in this wall, window is there. And in this wall also window is there. So we have to show the window portion here. Here. And repeat the same command. And here. Yeah. And repeat these patterns. Delete this. And this. Okay. Enter. There is no need of this. I'm just before that I just confirm whether door is there or not. Okay. There is no door cutted here. Okay. just delete that. And we have to show in the section window is like this as per the plan. Midpoint and again the offset 0.075 offset, frame thickness, glass thickness and all. Okay, so this is my window now. Escape, L enter and draw this. Okay, again offset 0.075 like this and like this. Yeah, this is my section now. Okay, so three walls with two cutted windows, slab and all. Okay, so in section we can find able to find the footing also. Okay, now we go for the footing. So this footing width and height will depend on the soil factor. Okay, but by standard we are going to take it as a 1 meter. Take this. So footing should be under the wall. Okay, just take a projection of 0.15. This is standard. And I'm taking it as a 1 meter. Okay. Again line, take 0.15 meter and 1 meter. This is our footing depth. So this is simple footing. Okay. So before this, we have to keep the bed concrete of 0.2 meter thickness. Okay. So for that, you just go 0.2. And extension of 0.15, yeah, 0.2, like this. Or else you can directly go to the rectangle and draw it like this. Okay. Same 0.15 projection and 0.2 and like this. Yes. And close the line. And trim this portion. No, delete that. Yeah, this is my bed now. Okay, you just select this portion like this and say join edge. Okay, or else you can select this and join. Yes, now same. This is my bed now. Hatch bed is made up of concrete. Give the hatch of concrete portion. Okay, and then apply and decrease the scale 0.01. Yes, and from here to here means 0.8 portion. Okay, 0.8 of the height contains the UCR, uncoursed rubble masonry. Okay, for that also go to the hatch and take UCR. UCR should be like this, one hatched one and one straight. Okay, this all we studied in the one of the subject of engineering, right? 1 meter, yes. Okay, so this is my footing. One more footing is there, stepped footing. Okay, we can divide it the portion of this 0.8. That will also I will just show here. Or else you can make it separately. Just draw a rough line and give the thickness of 0.3, sorry, offset of 0.3 and line 0.15. And we can divide the 0.8 portion, that is 0.4 height. Again 0.15 extension, 0.4 height. Again 0.15 extension. This is, we called it as a step footing. Okay. And again 1 meter width. You can copy it or you can do the same process. Okay, mirror this MI and then for midpoint. No, I have to take this line. Yes. Line should be from here to here so that I will get the exact mirror. Just take this and mirror. Okay, so now midpoint of this line somewhere here. Yeah, so select this, or else you can draw it 0.4, 0.15, 0.4, 0.15, like this. Okay. So as we called it as a bed, go to the rectangle and close this. Zoom it and REC first corner and second corner. Okay. So same hatch and bed. Apply and change the scale 0.01. Okay. For this UCR, if you can't understand, just chat me, okay? I'll repeat that process. Yes, go to the UCR. Okay, and increase the scale. Yes. So this is my step footing. Okay, I just delete this portion and copy this. Take a midpoint of this footing and then copy where you want to place. Okay, this and this. Yeah. So this is my section now. And by using the leader, you just give the names. Because retailing is must and should. 0.15 meter of CC means concrete. So we can give the grade also, that is M20, M30. Same like this, we have to continue the all the process detailing of that. Yeah, 0.6 meter of plane. Okay, filled with gravels like this. Okay. So I'm just showing the simple step here. Okay, in this way we are just going to draw the plan, section and elevation. Okay, you just name it. Okay. So I will show one plan here. Okay. So we have to do the same process like this. Okay. Can we able to see this screen? Just reply me in the chat box. I just opened one more plan, that is AutoCAD plan. Just reply me in the chat box. Yes, okay. So this is my plan, okay? So this is actually the layer is wall layer, okay? See. Because this plan is not in proper layer, so that it is not showing the... Yes. It is uniform, okay? See. So this is window. And we have to show at last opening of schedules, what we used. Door, as I told you, D, D1, D2. Okay, we have to show the dimensions what we used in the plan. Okay, what is the height of the door? Okay, what is the sill height? Sill height means from plinth to this one. In the elevation, I will just show you. Yeah. So this is my sill level. From here to here, this is sill level. And this is lintel level. So everything we have to show in the opening and schedule. Okay. And detailing, this is about the company name, when we do. As I thought Sonam Madam has told you how to create this page and all. Okay. And this is my first floor plan. We have to create it separately. And this is my elevation, design purpose and all. Okay. And this is also important. This is column, okay? Column drawing and this is foundation drawing. Okay, we can go to the demo plan and you can easily do that. Okay. Just if you want to provide the column, then make it here. Go for the rectangle. And as we all know that, what is the dimension of the rectangle? 0.3, enter 0.3. Okay, just make it separate layer for this. Just go to the new layer and see column and change the color if you want. Okay. Okay, select that column, keep it in that particular layer, and now just copy it. You have to change the point and then copy, okay? Here, for every corner we are going to show the columns. And the position of the columns we all decide depending on the design purpose that we studied in this SAD Pro. This and this. If the span exceeds 5 meter, then we have to provide the like this way. I'm just skipping this because it will take too much time. So create one more layer. This is my center line diagram. Okay, we have to create the center line and give the one more color for that. Okay, I will just give this color. Okay, and then close. Take a polyline and keep the center line diagram on, and you have to click on the center. Okay, here, yes, so just click on the center to center, like this and like this and like this. Okay, like this. Okay, here there is no column. I'm just assuming that because we have a time limit. Okay, here there is no column, I think, because the span is very small, like this and like this. Okay, here also. Okay, same, repeat the same process, line, and just join it like this. Yeah, and this is only, and this is my center line diagram. For footing also, what is the size of the footing? 1 meter by 1 meter. Okay, here only we can see the width. Okay, you just go ahead and I will just elaborate this plan so that you will get the idea. This is my column and this is my footing size. As you check this, yes, 0.9. It's depend on the soil factor as I told you earlier. Okay, this all we decide in the SAD Pro only, whether it is going to register the load or not. If it is registered, then we can take it as a 0.9. If not, then we can increase that width and all. Okay, this is the footing diagram. We have to do everything here, otherwise the drawing is incomplete. Anything you want to tell? Yes, ma'am, please tell how that create that page. I think Thursday madam has told you, na, Sonam madam. Nothing is there. You just create your own boundary. Just like this. Just keep the current layer as a wall. Okay, and give the offset for one particular format, 0.15 or like this. Okay. And go to the table as you learned the commands, right? Table. Here. Go for the table and give the number of columns and how much data rows you want. Okay, I'll just take it as like this. Okay, here you want to show the openings and schedules. Okay, that is D, D1, D2, W, W1, W2, like this. Okay, every company have their own format. Okay, you have to follow that format and you just make it the your own page format. Anything else? I hope you got it. Do you know the staircase plan? How to draw the staircase plan? Yes, anybody reply me? Hello? Okay, then you need a staircase plan, right? Okay. Okay, for example, I'm just assuming the room here. First, I will just tell you the how to draw a plan. Okay. So here, I will just, can you know the thickness of the thread 0.3. Okay, so before going to draw a plan, we just calculate the number of steps. Okay, so as we all know that floor to floor distance is 3 meter. Okay, how much? 3 meter. We just recheck it. Okay, 3 meter. And what is the height of the riser? 0.15. Okay, just divide it. 3 divided by 0.15. Then we will get a steps as 20. Okay, 20 steps. I just don't want to show in single leg. I just want to show in this double leg. Okay, I just show you that 3 meter of the height and 1 meter for the landing, and width of the stair is 1 meter. And again 4 meter including the landing. Okay, again L. Okay, 1 meter for the, sorry, before that we just provide the railing width 0.2. yeah, 4 meter and line take 1 meter and again 4 meter. Okay, so for landing purpose, offset 1 meter. Escape, offset 1 meter. You just give it like this. Yes. Okay. And you join this and trim this portion, because this is my landing and this is my railing, and this is 10 steps and here also 10 steps. Okay. You just draw a line here. This is my single step and give the offset, that is thread width 0.3. 0.3, how much steps? As I told you, 10 steps. Okay. Before going to plan, we have to calculate what is the total height and divided by riser of that step. Okay. You just calculate this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay. You just copy the same here. Copy and paste. This is my staircase plan. Any doubt? You just measure it. 0.3 into 10 means we get 3 meter. And 1 meter for the landing purpose. Yes. And what is the width? 1 meter. And 1 meter plus 0.2 for the railing purpose. That is 2.2. Yes. So this is my staircase plan. Same. How to draw staircase in section? Yes. In sections also you just start it. Elaborate this plan. Okay. For example, if you want to start from here, you just start and give the riser 0.15 and thread 0.3, 0.15, 0.3. You have to repeat the same process. Or else you can do the copy. 0.15. So how much steps? As I told you, 10 steps, right? Or else you can divide it for 1.5 meter. What is the height? 3 meter, right? Okay, give the height as 1.5. Yes. So up to 1.5, I have to continue the same process. 0.3, 0.15, 0.3, 0.15, 0.3, 0.15, 0.3, and 0.15. Okay. So after this, I just found my landing here. That is about 0.15 thickness. Okay. Give that offset 0.15 like this and just close it here. Yes, and trim this portion. Okay, and again you have to mirror this portion. Okay, mirror. Do you want to erase? No. Okay, and then you just draw a one. Bottom side of the staircase. Yes. We have to calculate it manually, right? What is the degree of inclination and all? Or else you can just mirror it. Mirror means, okay. Just drop a bit and then like this. Or else you can start it like this. And this slab and all is made up of the concrete only. We just trim the unwanted portion and go for the hatch. Okay, as I shown here. Wait. Yes, I will show you that section. Yes. Are you getting my point? See, thread and riser. You have to continue up to the 10 steps and again the landing and again the 10 step. If you have multi-story, again you just copy it or mirror it and continue the same process. Getting? Reply me? Yes, okay. Any other doubts? Okay, like this way. You have to create the blocks also because we are not an interior, no? So there is no need of showing the interior parts and all. If you want, then you can go when you are free, no? That time you just create this portion. So see, these are all made by me, okay? By using these blinds and all, trees. And these are the sofa, okay? You just copy it. Control C. Don't use this copy, otherwise it will not happen. Press Control C and go to our plan and just Control V. Okay? So paste it like this. Yes, this is my sofa. And you just move it in the corner. In this way, we are just showing all the components. If you learn Revit now, so there is no need of drawing this manually. The software itself will give the all the interior portions with the layer. There is no need of making layers, multiple layers and draw and all. Yes, this is not selecting. Okay. No. Okay, we just again Control C. Just go to the blocks. Control C and then Control V. Okay. Okay. And rotate this. Rotate. Keep it on. Okay, like this. And place where you want. Show. Yes. Like this way we are going to show the table and all. You just go to the rectangle. As all you know the commands, right? How much design you want, you just show it like this. And legs of the table, just copy it and place it. Okay. Take it off. Like this. So this is my tea table. And if you want to show the TV stand and all, you can show here like this. So in toilet also, just press the Control 3. Go to the tool palette and we have a toilet block here. Just drag and place. Okay. Then close. I want plan now. Okay. So click high here and go to the arrow mark and just click on the plan now. Yeah. And just rotate this. You can do the mirror also. So we rotate. Okay. Keep the effect on. Okay. And then rotate, or else you can give the 90 degree also. Merge and place it like this. Any other doubts? Okay. Shall I show you one more plan with detailing? Okay. Wait. Yeah, I'll just show you one learn plan. You have to practice, otherwise you will not get. Okay, you have to practice with the layers. Okay. Are you able to see my screen? Just reply me. Yes. Okay. So this is my parking area. See, these are all done in using layers only. Okay. So this is my entrance gate. These are my tiles, and this is basic lawn, and this basic sit out area. This is green area, and this is multi-purpose hall, functioning hall, and this is site office. Okay. So here toilet, indoor game purpose, and this is my stage. Okay, marriage stage. Whatever it may be. Okay, this is my lawn, and these are all the normal common rooms, C1, C2, C3. Okay, these are all the combined rooms. These are the beds. Okay, beds. Okay, this toilet, attached toilet. Okay, like this. Like this, we have to show everything in the plan. Okay, if you want, then I will show one more plan. Is there any doubt? Hostel plan and all, okay. Okay, I'm going to search. Okay, here it is. Is there any doubt in the plan section and elevation? Okay. If you people want to interested in some other softwares like 3D, like Revit, SketchUp and STAT, then I will show some reference or some projects done by my students, earlier students. Are you people interested to see how to decrease or increase the size of the object? Which object? You just scale it, na? Object means I'm not getting you, like furniture and all, car and toilet. Yeah, I just told you yesterday. You just change the scale of that room. Yeah, you just select this and I just copy this. I will show you how that. Okay. Okay. So if I want to increase or decrease, then you just click on this, right click, properties, and change the scale. Okay. Two. You have to change all x, y, z. This. If I want to decrease, then say repeat the same process. Go to the properties and change. Any doubt? If you want to change the view of that toilet, like front, side, and all, then go for this arrow. Okay. Click on this arrow and side like this. Side. Run like this. Okay. Any doubt? You just press Control 3 for the tool palette and drag and place. You will get everything there. If you not, then you have to create my own, like sofa and all. Any other doubts? If you people want to see the projects in Revit, SketchUp, and STAT, then I will show you. If you learn Revit now, then there is no need of this creating the layers and all. The software will automatically give the plan with the layers, actually. Yes, okay. I will just show you the plan. Yes. Are you able to see one plan, simple plan, so that I will confirm my screen is shared or not? Just reply me. Yes. Okay. So this is the project. Okay. Just I will show. This project is done at the Revit. Okay. Wait for a moment. Okay, so this is the section. Okay, as I told you, we have to create the footings and the splint level. Either it may be a gravel or it may be divided into boulders, morum, and PCC. Just as I told you, go to divide that portion of 0.6 meter and give the particular hatch portion. Okay, and this is the project done at the rivet. These are all the normal when the students were practicing, na? So that time they did like this. Okay. This is the rivet one. This is also project done in the rivet. The front elevation. Software itself will be give the all the elevation. There is no need of creating the front side elevation and all. Okay. If you create the plan, then software will give the 3D front elevation, side elevation and all. There is no need of doing it separately. Okay. This is my plan. This is one of the flat system. Okay. Like this. These are all the simple plans actually. I will just show you the okay. This is StadPro project, okay? As we called it as a framework, and this is shear wall, okay? In if you admit that software, then I will tell you detail how it works actually. These are all the load patterns, wall load, and this is the footing. No need of drawing this, okay? StadPro itself will give the drawings of this detailing bars and all. As we calculated in the manual engineering, right? Yeah, this is my column plan, footing plan, detailing of that plan. Okay, footing, truss, tower, electrical tower, and this is the plan done in the rivet. Okay, see, there are the, and this is the front elevation. Yeah, this is not. Actually, this one, this is not, these are all the reference projects. Okay. Is it fast? See, these are the rivet projects. Okay. Same way, yeah, this is also. Okay, by using the Photoshop and all, we can create the background like this. Interior view. Okay. These are all happen due to the low configuration of the that PC and the laptop. Okay. If you have good PC and all, this problem will not get. Yes, lighting. Exterior, nightlife, night view. This one. These are the interior views. Sorry. See. Okay. Still more projects are there that I'm showing to you. These are all the practicing level projects. Final projects are there. I will show you. Wait for a moment. Yeah, otherwise I will just send you in the group also. Okay. I think I have to search the file. Yes. Is there any doubt in the softwares what we did in the rivet and SketchUp and STAD? Instead, we just analyzing it. Means what is the size of the column? What is the size of the beam? Is it able to bear the load or not? Okay, like this way. Okay, we have to STAD. We are going to use for the analysis and design purpose, and for 3D purpose, we are going to use the rivet and SketchUp also. And to enhance the photorealistic view, we just going to use the V-Ray. Okay. That is render plugin actually. Any other doubt? Yes. Reply in the chat box. No. Okay, I will just show you one slide here that is of stat blue. All of you are from civil only, right? Give me 2 minutes. Okay, I'm just sharing that screen. Okay. Are you able to see my screen? That is Stat Pro. Just reply me. Yes, okay. So, okay, this is StatPro. Okay, StatPro means Structural Analysis and Design. Okay, so earlier in our college days, we are doing the design and analysis manually, right? So it will take too much time to analyze and design, okay? So in order to overcome that problem, we are going to use the StatPro software, okay? For this StatPro software, we should give the inputs, okay? We have to draw a plan. Okay, that plan is consisting of the supports and structures and loads. Okay, this is our input. So depending on that input, software will give the reactions. Okay, there is no need of calculating the manual. Okay, all are fine with the Marathi or English only? Okay. So software itself will give the reactions and all, okay? First, in input, we just create the structure, okay? After that, creating the structure, we are giving to, okay? Okay, no problem. तर आपल्याला काय करावं लागतं? आधी स्ट्रक्चर बनवावं लागतं, ठीक आहे? तर मग स्ट्रक्चर बनवलं की त्याच्यानंतर आपल्याला सपोर्ट द्यायचा. तर सपोर्ट मध्ये परत आपण 3 टाइप्स बघतो की फिक्स्ड सपोर्ट, हिंज्ड सपोर्ट, रोलर सपोर्ट. ओके, तो डिपेंडिंग ऑन दी कंडिशन आपण काय करणार? सपोर्ट अप्लाय करणार. ओके, तर एकदा स्ट्रक्चर कंप्लीट झालं की मग नंतर आपण स्टेपला जातो की सपोर्ट. सपोर्ट झालं की मग नंतर आपण काय करतो? लोड. लोड म्हणजे काय? काय लोड अप्लाय करतो आपण? डेड लोड. डेड लोड म्हणजे त्याचं स्वतःचाच वेट. ओके, तर जे काय आपण मॅन्युअली कॅल्क्युलेट करतो ना, समजा आता आपलं एक बीम असेल की 10 मीटरचं आणि त्याची क्रॉस सेक्शन असेल 0.3 0.3, आणि मग ते कसं कॅल्क्युलेट करतो आपण? 0.3 × 0.3 क्रॉस सेक्शन झालं त्याची, आणि मग त्याची लेंथ काय आहे? 10 मीटर × 10 मीटर. आणि तो बीम कशाचा आहे? कॉन्क्रीटचा आहे, ठीक आहे? मग कॉन्क्रीटची युनिट डेन्सिटी काय आहे? 25. तर हे सगळ्या गोष्टी आपल्याला मॅन्युअली करावं लागतं की 0.3 × 0.3 × 10 × 25. ओके, तर हा खूप वेळ घेतो ना. आता आपल्याला फक्त एक सिंगल बीम बनवण्यासाठी इतकं वेळ जर घेतलं तर आपण कसं पूर्ण बिल्डिंग डिझाईन करणार? इट विल टेक टू मच टाइम. सो त्याच्यासाठी आपण काय करतो, स्टॅट ब्रो यूज करतो. ओके, तर लोड देणार, मग डेड लोड अप्लाय करणार, लाई लोड अप्लाय करणार. लाई लोड कसा अप्लाय करणार, तर आपण ऑलरेडी कोड स्टडी केलेला आहे, इंडियन कोड्स IS 456 यूज करत होतो आपण कॉन्क्रीट साठी, आणि लोडिंग साठी यूज करतो आपण IS 875. हा सगळ्या गोष्टी तुम्हाला कोर्स मध्ये फुल डिटेल मध्ये होऊन जाईल. ठीक आहे, तर मग स्ट्रक्चर म्हणजे ते स्ट्रक्चर कसं असतं. आधी आपल्याला एक पर्टिक्युलर पॉइंट, आता समजा बीम जर ड्रॉ करायचा असेल तर इथे एक पॉइंट आणि इथे एक पॉइंट, त्याला म्हणतो आपण जॉईंट. ओके, तर दोन्ही जॉईंट मिळून आपल्याला काय होत असतं, एक बीम होत असतं, मग त्याला आपण मेंबर म्हणतो. ठीक आहे, तर असं जॉईंट्स आणि मेंबर हा दोन्ही मिळून काय होणार आहे, स्ट्रक्चर क्रिएट होणार आहे. तर हा कसं असतं, आधी 2D मध्ये असतं, तर मग त्याच्या 3D मध्ये कन्वर्ट करण्यासाठी आपण काय करतो, त्याला मेटेरियल इज नथिंग बट क्रॉस सेक्शन देणार, की त्याची बीमचा साईज काय आहे, कॉलमचा साईज काय आहे. तर ऑलरेडी आपण बघितलं ना प्लॅन मध्ये 0.3 म्हणून, मग ते थिकनेस आणि डेप्थ वगैरे आपण काय करणार, मेटेरियल मध्ये डिफाईन करणार. ओके, सी, सो दिस इज मेंबर अँड स्ट्रक्चर, असं आपण त्याला 0.3 देणार. नेक्स्ट, तर आधी कसं असतं, ज्योमेट्री आपलं 2D फॉर्मॅट मध्ये असतं, तर मग 2D टू 3D कसं कन्वर्ट करायचा, लाईक दिस. ओके, तर नंतर त्याला आपण लोड टाकणार, डेड लोड, लाईव लोड, विंड लोड असेल तर विंड लोड वगैरे. सो शो अदर सॉफ्टवेअर स्टार्ट करते, या आय विल शो इट. ओके, दीज आर ऑल दी फिक्स्ड सपोर्ट. हे कधी अप्लाय करायचं आहे, का अप्लाय करायचं आहे, तुम्हाला कोर्स मध्ये सगळं भेटून जाईल. ओके, लोड, सेल्फ लोड, पॉइंट लोड वगैरे. तर मेंबर कोर्स मध्ये परत ते आउटपुट मध्ये देतं आपल्याला की काय स्ट्रेसेस येत आहेत आपल्याला आउटपुट मध्ये. ओके, आणि नो नीड टू कॅल्क्युलेट मॅन्युअली. FX, FY, FZ जे काय आपण मॅन्युअली कॅल्क्युलेट करत होतो ना, ते आपल्याला सॉफ्टवेअर इटसेल्फ ओनली देऊन टाकतो. नंतर आपण डिझाईनला जाणार, तर बिल्डिंग जर कॉन्क्रीटचं असेल आपण कॉन्क्रीट डिझाईन करणार, किंवा जर स्टीलचं असेल लाईक टॉवर, स्टील टॉवर आणि ट्रस वगैरे असेल, तर आपण ट्रसला जाणार. ओके, तर हा आपलं स्टॅड प्रो आहे. देन इफ यू पीपल वॉन्ट टू सी द रिव्हिट, देन आय विल शो इट. ओके, all are there, right? Yes, I just open one here. Just wait for a minute. Just wait for a moment. All are there, right? Just reply me. All of you, Rohit. Yeah. Yes, yes. Just it will take some time to open. Yes, have you people done the practice what I told you yesterday? Just reply me until the Revit opens. Yes, Rohit, Ashwini, and Kepki, I think. Right? Am I right? प्रैक्टिस केले तुम्ही सगळे लेयर्स यूज करून प्लान कसा ड्रॉ करायचा. यस एनीबडी. यस व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स. नाही केलं का? We have to practice. Wait for a moment. I'm just opening all the softwares at a time so that it will take time. Are you able to see my screen, Revit? Yes. Yes. Okay. So this is the Revit software. Okay, I'm just showing one project. So this is my plan view. This is just a plan. Okay, so I want to see the 3D. In single click, you just get the 3D. Okay, yes, 3D only. No need to do it separately. So simple plan. Are we able to see? Yes. Okay. So this is my 3D. If I want to see the front view, then you just click on the one option. Yes, this is my front. Okay. Still it is progressing project, not completed one. Okay. So this is my north view, east view, and this is my north view. Okay. And south view. If you want to keep in wireframe, then you can add. So you can just keep it in realistic. Okay, Sarasana. प्रत्येक डायरेक्शन मधून सुद्धा ते सॉफ्टवेअर काय करतं आपल्याला एलिव्हेशन देऊन टाकतं. नॉर्थ असू द्या, ईस्ट, साऊथ, वेस्ट असं. ठीक आहे, तर आपल्याला परत 3D बघायचं असेल तर आपण 3D बघू शकतो. तर अजून काही आपल्याला चेंजेस करायची असेल तर आपण काय करतो, परत प्लॅन मध्ये जाणार. ओके, तर मग प्लॅन मध्ये जाऊन आपण असं बऱ्यापैकी चेंजेस करू शकतो. मी फक्त एक रफ डायग्राम दाखवते तुम्हाला कसं करायचं वगैरे. ओके, इथे काय असतं, वॉल असतं. तर तो वॉल आधी आपल्याला युनिट लेवल्स वगैरे सगळं बेसिक जे गोष्टी आहेत ते करावं लागतं. तर जसं आपलं रूम आहे आणि हा प्लॅन फीट आणि इंचेस मध्ये आहे, ठीक आहे, तर मी आता सिम्पल रूम जरी ड्रॉ केला तर आता हा कर्टेन वॉल मध्ये आहे. त्याच्या आधी आपल्याला त्याला ब्रिक वॉल मध्ये कन्वर्ट करावं लागेल. हा सगळ्या गोष्टी तुम्हाला कोर्स मध्ये भेटेल. ओके, तर कसं त्याची थिकनेस द्यायचा. ओके, आता मी फक्त एक डेमो देते. तर हा माझी प्लॅन व्ह्यू आहे. ओके,
एक्सक्यूज मी मॅम.
येस येस
मॅम, आपला रिव्हिट आणि 3ds मॅक्स मध्ये काय डिफरन्स आहे मॅम?
ओके, 3ds मॅक्स मध्ये कसं असतं, आता हा रिव्हिट मध्ये फुल डिटेलिंग करू शकतो आपण. जर आपल्याला प्रोजेक्ट करायची आहे